Hello, Bard haters, and welcome to another fine We Hate Bards Let's Play. I'm Ben, and this is more Fire Emblem. Last time, we defeated Eric, and we're told that the bad guys had moved further inland to a place called Caelin, where a friend of Elwood's named Lynn, or Lindis, I guess, technically, lives. A character who you haven't seen in this playthrough yet, but who was in the main character in the prologue, or the first 10 missions, rather. So we're going to go and check in on her, and I'm sure she'll be perfectly fine and not in any danger whatsoever. You know, I'm starting to think also it might not be a coincidence that the name of the territory owned by the trader is Louse. Which is a plural of... Actually, would that be Louse or Lout? I think Lout is the word I'm thinking of. Because Louse is just the plural of lice. Or no, singular of lice. Lice is plural. Louse is singular. So he's a louse, apparently. And yep. Oh, another cutscene. Now he's a snake as well as being a little mite. Ah, there we go. A bit more foreshadowing. Burn has also been doing weird things over the past several months. And now things are happening in Lycia, but we'll end up seeing what's up with Burn later. First, we have to defeat Darin. Oh man, you know, you wouldn't think you'd have problems with allergies in October in Michigan, but apparently I do. Oh man. Well, at least you can admit it, Hector. At least you can admit that you're a terrible human being. Oh no, something's happened! A messenger's come, and Castle... Oh no, bad things happened to Castle Caelin. I was wrong! They're actually in trouble. Yeah, so now we have to go and help out Caelin, and we'll get to meet several characters from the prologue that you haven't had a chance to see yet. And there they all are, all five of them. Which is kind of cool, because it means you get five new characters in this part. Or five returning characters in this part. So, Lynn is obviously one of them. She's the swordsman. She's, again, the main character. Then you have two cavaliers, Sane and Kent, who are right there. There's also an archer named Will, who is right there. And then the other one is a Pegasus knight named Florina, and I don't think I have... talk about Pegasus Knights yet, because we haven't seen any. Oh yeah, and so, that's the other thing that's going on. Apparently, in addition to attacking people and causing chaos, they're also blaming this whole thing on Elwood. So, Will offered volunteers to go. But then Florina, who is the Pegasus Knight, who is very awkward around men, says that she'll do it. Yes, again, another bit of story you guys don't get to see, but in the prequel, she was very, very shy and awkward. She didn't really like men, and now... But apparently, since a year has passed since the last bit, she can now talk to men. It's kind of like the reverse Rajesh Kuthrapali, really. Although, I'm curious if Florina would have been able to talk to men if she'd been drunk, because we never actually saw her drunk. But, oh no! There's a Pegasus Knight! Let's go shoot it down! So, that's actually a little, I don't want to say necessarily reference, but it's, the idea is that Pegasus Knights are very vulnerable to arrow fire, given the fact that they fly, because arrows are the only things that can reach them, and especially in the sky, because truth be told, if you're a flying thing, and like, I know in D&D they have flying things as being like awesome, or not D&D, most other media flying things are awesome and just like destroy stuff. But in actuality, if you had wings and were able to fly above your foes, they could just like shoot you down. And then you'd fall and die. That's actually a thing D&D did address, because if you take damage while flying, you have to make like a bunch of checks and saves, and if you fail them, you fall to the ground from whatever height you were at, and take 1d6 damage per every 10 feet you fell. So if you're flying like 200 feet, you're basically dead. And that's basically what happened here. She was flying too high above the sky, and then she got shot down and fell to the ground. Oh wait, no, they actually missed her, but she just lost her balance. And she'll tell us that Lynn is waiting just beyond the set of houses over there. And we're... Oh, now they found out that we're here. So, we get to pick our units, and that's what we'll do. Why does Elwood have a lance? Moreover, what? Oh, wait, no. I was say, why is it saying that he can actually use it? He can't. Trade. I think I... No, I didn't want him to use the Iron Blade because he... Did I? I don't remember giving him an Iron Blade. I'm not sure how that all works. Marcus, I know I gave all this stuff to because I wanted him to have backup stuff for his steel. Loen, yep. Oswin, Hector. Bartre, Guy. I might give Guy the Iron Blade. Rather than just an iron sword. As for you, you're gonna store your goddess icon for now. Goddess icon for now, until I figure out what to do with it. Alright. Here we go. Oh. I think I said I was gonna have give Guy the Iron Blade, and that's what I'll do. We'll have a silver lance and nothing else. Other than a bunch of just random stuff. So, now that we've kind of got our units equipped appropriately, let's see who we want to have go in with us. We'll undo everyone. And it might just be we might just end up leaving Marcus. Although, actually, Marcus is a bit of an experience sponge early on because he starts out as an upgraded unit. And admittedly, his stats are a bit low for an upgraded unit. Now, the one thing I was actually looking at, and I don't know if I've mentioned this before, I might have mentioned this in an earlier part, but Marcus's, what is it, his growth is actually some of the highest in the game for most of his stats. He has some of the higher growth percentages. So, yeah, early game he's an experience sponge, then mid-game he's a bit underpowered as you're trying to get him leveled back up, but late-game he becomes useful again, weirdly enough. It's just the middle game that he's just kind of... you know, not as good. So we can use 11, we have 12, we would have 13, except we lost an archer, unfortunately. But like I said, we just picked up another one, so we'll at least have an archer going forward. Alright, so who do I want to leave behind is a question. Who does not need to join in the fighting? Check the map. Yeah. Mind you, we also have two more cavaliers, a swordsman, and an archer for coming from over the, from down in this area. So, a lot of swordsmen. A couple mages, which we have Florina for. A couple archers, and... Alright, so I really only should need more than one axeman, so I can probably just leave Bartray and I should be okay. Pick the units. Or not Bartray, Dorcas. Bartray I'll probably take with me. Actually, do I want to leave Bartray behind and take Dorcas with me? Because Bartray's not... At some point here, I'm going to need to start specifying who's going to be my actual, like, starting lineup. Because you're not going to be able to max out all these units without cheating. Which admittedly I could do, but I'm not going to. I'm not going to use cheat codes for this because, again, that's... Well, it's not as interesting to watch. But you could theoretically use cheat codes to give them max experience and, you know, max at the level. Without that, I am going to have to prioritize which units I want to get leveled up, and I think Dorcas is going to be one of the ones that I take into the late game. Bartray, he's not... From research, he's just not that great. I mean, he's okay on strength, but everything else is kind of shit. Dorcas at least has decent defense. Or he will. Yeah, I think Dorcas might be more worth my time. So I'm going to leave Bartray behind. I'm taking everyone else with me. And, yep, that should be okay. I mean, arguably, I don't need two healers, but that was the other thing I was considering. I was considering leaving Sarah behind. Actually, I might almost do that. No, I'm going to be cautious. I'm going to be super cautious. And, hold on. Just in case something happens with the record. So, should be good. Wasn't ready. Wasn't really ready yet. That's another reason I'm glad I did that. Because I didn't actually get a chance to specify where I wanted all these people. So, we're going to need our cavalry units out in the front. So, Loen is going to be our primary cavalry unit. Marcus will be good right here. We also want our slower units like Oswin out in front. And Hector to a lesser degree. Dorcas as well. This will be our front line. And then Matthew can move decent speed, so I'll probably put him back here. As for this, I'll move her up. And, well, here's the other thing, too. I'm going to need to move some people over across the hill, which is probably going to end up being Irk and Dorcas. And actually, you know what? Do I want to send Matthew with him, or do I want to just send... I might just send Sarah over with them. Because, again, they're going to start sending people, not horses, obviously, but they're going to have, like, bandits and brigands or axemen or whatever, who come from this direction. So I want to figure out how many people I need to commit to that side. Definitely these two, probably, and Sarah, possibly Matthew. And then Elwood and the rest of these guys are going to go down this way. So, that's, I think that'll do it. Save again, and now we should be good to start. Erlinus is level 6, we'll deploy him. Boom. Yep. Alright. So now we're ready to go. So as I said, step one is we're going to need to get Dorcas up here, and I'm going to have him equipped with a steel axe, because he's going to need to be able to do a lot of damage real quick. And Sarah will start working on getting over there. She won't make it quite yet. Marcus and Loen are going to hold the guard right here. Oh, right, I forgot. Wait. Was Florina on that map? I don't think she was. I forgot I had Florina as well, so I can probably... Because now I'm trying to figure out exactly how I want to do this, because I could send Florina up here to help him deal with it. Problem is, one, she's only level 3, and two... she's vulnerable to arrows. Three, they're sending axemen this way, which axes are good against lances, but poor against swords. So if I send Matthew, I think I'm gonna do it that way. And then I'll have Florina sort of, let's visit. Let's see what we get from here. Oh, it's just telling us that, you know, you can do things. Okay. And then we'll move everyone else up a little bit. Including Elwood. Move her over here. Now, how do I want to deal with Florina? Because I'm definitely going to need to send her up to deal with that mage. She's the only one who's really going to be effective. Oh, and I have these guys as well. I forgot to move them. What do they even have? I think he has... Okay, he has a steel lance and an iron sword, and he can use steel everything. And so can... Right, she still has a Manny Caddy. That's a unique sword that she gets, by the way. Which also means I may need to buy her an iron sword. I think the first little bit of this is gonna be... oh, jeez. Something got caught in my nose there. That was bizarre. I think the first little bit of this is gonna be me just trying to lure people down here, while Lynn can't go and deal with... Ah, here we go. So we'll have her buy Iron Sword for herself, Steel Sword for herself, and, I want to buy more Steel Swords. That could be actually useful. I'll buy a Steel Axe for Bartray. And I don't think anyone else... Actually, you know what? Steel Axe for Hector as well. And then we should be good. And I'm spending a lot of money, I realize, to do this, but it's kind of worth it for me. He can use the Steel Lance, he cannot use the bow. Buy a couple of those. Buy another javelin. And another iron lance. And that should be good for now. And then because he's a cavalry unit, he can actually move twice, so I can actually move him forward still. I don't know what they have in here. I think they just have... Oh, they have a fire, which I might even send Urk down here to pick one of those up. Because the thunder is going to run out fairly quickly. Alternatively, I could just have... Ooh, I forgot! Will, okay, he has an iron bow and a steel bow. I was thinking, like, I don't need to buy bows, I don't have an archer anymore, but I do now. I do have an archer, in fact. I'm gonna send my archer down here to buy just one... Actually, I'm gonna buy fire, and... Oh, I can't buy a heal. Okay, I was gonna buy a heal staff as well for... Can't even remember her name. Priscilla, because she has a mend, and that'll get used up quickly. Then we'll have... Dude, come out here. Left Sane. He's equipped with Lance, so he'll have an advantage against those guys. And finally, we will send Florina down here to just chill by this village. Alright, so that's the first round, and most of this is just going to be them moving. Other than that. Alright, he's going to attack Loen. Loen's going to kill it. Well, do some damage to him. Ah, Loen leveled up. HP and defense. Largely, that's actually that's all you want your cavaliers to get. You don't... Strength isn't necessarily... I mean, you want to, don't want the strength to get completely neglected, but strength isn't as important. Alright. Now it's our turn again. So. Yeah, they... I could have sworn they get axe guys up here. I don't see any, though. So what we're going to do instead, we're going to have Dorcas wait. Urk is going to cast Thunder on this guy, and... Ooh! Actually, that's not as big of a deal as I thought. Because he is going to take some damage out of this. Well, if it hits him, it's only at a 50% chance of hitting. So, yeah, not even a bit... Oh! That's not as good. That could... Actually, does he have a javelin? No. Does he have a javelin? Obviously not. So there's nothing else that can really hit him anyway. So yeah, he's fine for now. Alright, he's fine. Yeah, I was thinking, like, oh, if it gets too bad, I can always just have, Sarah heal him. So that works. Now, as for the rest of these guys... Actually, we'll do this first, because these guys aren't going to be as deadly. Will can finish up the guy with the bow. Actually, does he need to, or can... Okay, Lin can't even get anywhere, so we'll just move her up for now. Will, come over, use his iron bow. Uh-oh. Crap, I was really hoping that would kill him. Whoops. Well, this looks like he should kill this guy in one. Assuming he hits, he may not. That seems to be kind of the order of the day so far. Again, I say every time, I apologize for the fast-forward. I'm trying to keep these... Or fast-forwarding. I'm trying to keep the, time on these down. Right now I'm going to have him use an Iron Lance, and that'll kill him. Oh, excuse me. Then there's that guy there. Okay. I think I'm going to start... Ooh, how do I want to start this? Also, what does she have? A Slim Lance and a Javelin. Oh, well, Slim Lance isn't great, but it'll work for now. Alright. Big thing, biggest thing of this, make sure Florina stays completely out of range of any archers at all times. Because again, archers do a ton of damage, And even with like a low amount of damage, even like a base, you know, low NPC amount, an archer could still probably one-shot Florina. So that would mean I'd lose. Pegasus Knights are actually good units, if you level them off. They take some work to get them decent, but once they're there, you know, they're good. I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to have Guy get started on this one with an Iron Blade. Ooh, he's going to get to attack twice if I do that. Alternatively, if I use an Iron Sword on him, actually, this might almost be worth breaking out the Killing Edge, because at this point, especially if he crits, which doesn't look like he's going to do. So yeah, it took some damage, not as bad as it would have been. Then we can have Florina go over, and, oh, dick biscuits. Alright, if this hits, it'll kill him. If not, we might... Okay. There we go. So she's fine, that's all good. Now... I'm actually gonna have Osmond chuck a spear at this guy. Yeah, because that'll clear up an area for Marcus to go through, which is what I really want. What weapon is he equipped with? A lance? Can I get Hector over there? No, I can't. But I can get Lowen there, and that means... Oh, I don't want to use sword, I want to use lance! Lance! Lance's face! And he will miss, so everything is fine. In that case, I can then move... I can't do anything with him yet, but I can move Marcus forward at least, and fill in the gaps with everyone else. And I'll have Priscilla right there to assist anyone who needs it. Alright, so that's... I don't think I'm going to kill him, because I don't think Kent's strong enough yet. Also, he's only using iron, so that's another negative. Oh, you're going to go after my upgraded unit, are you? Who has a better weapon than you? That's unfortunate. Oh, it didn't kill him. I thought that was gonna Marcus was gonna one-shot him. All right. Yep, he's gonna take some damage from the mage. I kind of figured that was gonna happen. And Javelin is gonna go after. Ooh, got Urk this time. But now he's dead, so now there's nothing to worry about. And Urk's gonna gain a level. Yes. What is he gonna get? HP, magic, defense, not bad. Ah, there we go. There's the fuckers, right there. Told you they'd be showing up soon. Alright. Now I need to think of the best way to do this. Because here's the point where it's going to get a bit trickier. Lin should be fine by herself, especially given that there's only two people who could theoretically attack her, and one is a fucking thief. Yeah, like 8 attack, I don't even know if that can overcome her. Well, it might, because she's only... Yeah, it'll do almost no damage to her, she'll be fine. And actually, I could probably have Sane just go up and kill him anyway, which is what I'm going to do. Because he can't do much else this round. And dude with sword goes down. HP, strength, and defense, awesome. As for this guy... I'm gonna have Will hang back for a bit and just see if we can finish him off. Come on, please hit him. Please hit him. Thank you. Yeah, that can be kind of annoying when they don't hit. Ooh, Horse Slayer. Here's the other thing I'm gonna do, since I have Sane up, so I don't really need Kent there as well. We're gonna have him go here. And he's going to give us a heavy spear. Which is actually gonna be really useful if I decide to have Kent go up against... Is this Kent? Yeah. Because as he was telling us, heavy spears are good against armored units, which the commander is. He's a knight. Yeah, he's a knight. I was thinking general for a second, but no, he's a knight. And so having a horse unit with a heavy spear means that I will do extra damage to him. I'll overcome all of his defense. Which means that I might even end up giving it to Sane and having Sane do it, because Sane's a little tougher. Yeah, I always prefer Sane over Kent. He just generally seems stronger. I think Kent has higher speed. Oh, nope, same speed. I don't know the advantage of Kent then. I really don't. Yeah, I used to know, like, individual breakdowns of, like, stats and stat growths and everything, but now I don't. Now I have no freaking idea how it all works. who I am going to do. And have Sarah heal Urk, because Urk is going to be the guy that ends up going after him. But before we go there, not Priscilla, Florina, take out this guy. Finish him off for me, if you'd be so kind. He'll go down, she gains some experience, but not enough to level her up, unfortunately. As for... piss! Should have had her go after this guy. Well, who else is good? You know what? Guy. Fuck, Guy can't make it either. Too many fucking trees in the way. Damn it, this is a nightmare. Like, I want to move people places and then I can never move them there because I don't have enough movement to do so. Alright, here's what I'm going to do. I need Loen to move up immediately. So, Loen I'm going to heal and then I'm going to move Loen up to do a bit of tanky tank for, on this guy. There we go. Now, what's he using? Is he using a lance? So we'll move him up and we'll finish him off with Oswin. Good. Now, Hector. Can Hector do... Actually, the Wolf Bale does extra damage to infantry, and this counts as... Ah, fuck you. For some reason, his hit rates are really freaking low. I mean, granted, he's trying to hit someone in the trees, but still. How about Elwood? Will Elwood be better with the rapier? It does look like it, so let's have Elwood deal with this guy then. Yes, crit! One hit, one kill. I love it when that happens. So Elwood's gonna gain some speed, some HP, etc. Then we can move Hector forward, and then we can have Marcus come up here and try to draw off a couple extra attackers. Right, so that should be... Is he still using his steel stuff? I think he is. Then we'll move Guy forward as far as I can. And that's everyone here's moved. Alright. With that done, I'm now going to move Dorcas up, and this is where I might... I don't think I'll lose Dorcas right now, but it's definitely going to be problematic in a minute. I'll do less damage, but it'll higher to hit, and even if I hit with the other one, it wouldn't kill him anyway. So yeah, probably better just to go with Iron Axe for now. Oh, he's got a sword! That's why the hit rate's so low. Okay, that's definitely different. Fuck. Are you kidding me? Ah, damn it. Alright, so Matthew will have to take him on. Marcus will kill that swordsman. Yeah, I took quite a bit of damage from that guy, but... Luckily, the rest of these guys are lance users, so I should have advantage. And that... in and of itself might be enough to... Oh, he's a sword user! I lied! I did not have advantage on all of... I'm glad that did not do as much damage as I thought it was going to. I'm also glad they didn't move the mage up, because I just realized... Actually, is he even... Oh, he's not in range. He's one... If this guy was one space closer, Dorcas probably would be dead right now. So that's... Oh, that was rough. That was rough. Alright. We'll give Urk a chance to kill this guy, and he did. Sweet. Now, Dorcas, we're going to need to move you away from combat for now, because you are looking a bit beat up. In the meantime, I'm going to have Marcus come up, and I'm going to have him start using iron equipment, because it'll be better for him to do so. Oh, and he crit! Oh yes, Marcus is critting. That is 48 points of damage you just took, and you can only handle 20. Alright, HP, luck, and... Yeah, so we gained his first level. Supposedly his things should be going up at a higher rate than that, but oh well, we'll see what happens over the next several levels. I kind of want to stay out of reach of this guy for right now, so we'll just move Loen up here. He's going to have to use a lance because both of these guys... Well, he uses a sword, but he actually would have advantage if I did this, so... Loen's going to do some damage to this guy, he's going to do no damage to me, and that's that taken care of. So, now the rest of it is just moving the rest of my people up to help. that. And actually, no, she could probably might be able to do something, so I'll leave her back until I figure out what I want to do with her. Matthew is going to chill right here, because he's going to be the one dealing with the bandits. And actually, no, it doesn't look like I can do that, so I'll move Florina here for right now. Alright, we're getting really close. Oh, he's in a vulner area again, is he? And that was a very poor choice on your part, because he's going to kill you. Alright. Oh, he has a... What? You have a zero hit for... Oh, that is so awesome. These things have zero to hit against Matt. That is fantastic. Oh, no! No! Dorcas, I'm so sorry. Oh, shit, this is going terribly. I just lost Dorcas. Now I'm stuck with fucking... Oh. I'm stuck with a guy I didn't even bring with me this round. As a matter of fact, I specifically remember at the beginning of this video saying, oh, I'm not going to need Bartry. I'm going to focus on Dorcas because he's better. And now Dorcas is dead and I'm eating my words. Fuck. That's two down. That is definitely two down. Right. Well, carry on, I guess. I completely forgot that I should have had Florina rescue him. That would have been a much better idea. That might have worked. Yeah, I very distinctly need to pay more attention to my stronger units, because otherwise that bad things are going to happen to them like that. Considering doing this, I can't hit twice with that. If I did 4 more points of damage per hit, I would absolutely do this, because it would be a one-shot kill. Don't need her to do anything yet. Let's move Guy up so that I can move the rest of them up further. Will an Iron Sword be enough? Nope, how about an Iron Blade? I think I'm just going to get the experience for him anyway. And then, Florina. Ooh, do I want to have Florina do that? Sane should be alright if I move him up. That should be okay, having him here. Move Will up there. And then Kent right there. I think I'm going to have to use... would Oswin be able to make that? He could go over here in Javelin, which I'm going to attempt. And it hit. There we go. Now I'm going to move Elwood up, and I'm going to move Hector up as well. And then I'll have... Why'd I do that? For some reason I thought Guy took damage that time. I don't know why I thought that. Or maybe I thought he was going to, and then when he didn't, I just wasn't fucking paying attention. Alright. As for Marcus, he's going to come back here because he'll take a little bit of damage, but then he'll kill the mage. Yep, so he took 4 points of damage, but he has plenty of hit points. Plenty. And we have an extra thunder. Sweet! That means Perk can have an extra thunder if he so chooses. I'm actually trying to remember the next mage we get. Because we will get a, I know the very next mission we will get a light magic user, but I don't think he doesn't count as a mage. I think he's counted as a bishop. Or, crap, what do they call those things? I even know who it is. He was in the prologue missions, so... as for this guy, what would be the best thing to have Loen do right now? What would be the most prudent? Because Loen literally has taken zero damage to this point. So, it might almost be more prudent for me to have him go... like this. And be up there tanking with Marcus. Yep. And then we'll move Florina up here and try to keep her out of reach of that guy. The archer. Alright. Well, that sucks. He's gonna go after Sane, who's then going to miss. Good going, Sane. Glad I brought you along. He's also gonna go after Sane. Ah, there we go, that's better. And he's gonna go after Sane as well with his bow. Alright, at this point I probably am going to use Florina on the archer, just because I'm also going to completely ignore the bandit that just spawned, because that would require me going backwards. I'm gonna send her to deal with him right now. There we go. Now I'm gonna start with the guys at the back. I'm start moving him out because I don't think any more bandits are gonna spawn up there. If they do, I can move people back. It's fine. In the meantime, I'm gonna move all these people up. And actually, no, I won't be able to move you, will I? Oh, here's what I can do. Will, deal with that guy, would you? Fuck, you can't deal with that guy. That's unfortunate. I was really hoping like I get two shots with an iron bow and then he'd be dead. As for you though, if I use my rapier, actually, do I even need my rapier? Nope, I'm just gonna burn an iron sword. There we go. Alright, we'll go up here. Move him, and do I want to keep him there? Or do I want to try and... Actually, do I want to move Sane up here? That might almost be more prudent for me. Yep, because Sane can finish this guy off. Well, if he hits. That's the big if. Will he hit? Yes, he will! Alright. So that guy is dead. That guy is completely out of the picture. Sane's taking a bit of damage, too, but... As long as I can kill both of these guys in the next turn, I should be okay. Will Guy be able to get past that? I don't think he will. So who do we want? Do I want Guy to deal with it, or do I want Lin? I think I want Guy, because Guy needs the experience. So we'll have Guy go up, and an Iron Sword will be enough to kill him in one. Oh, and he crits as well! Well done, you. Well done, Mr. Swordsmaster. Oh, wait, you're not a Swordsmaster. Yes, you w- yeah, you will be. And then, you better fucking hit, you loser, because seriously, this lack of hitting things is really, okay. It's 63 to hit, that's terrible. I don't know if it's just because his skill is so low, or because he's used his axes, but it seems like even Dorcas was getting a better hit rate than that. Okay. Now. Who needs heals? You're fine, you're fine, you're fine. You guys are all absolutely fine. Elwood's fine. Ah, Sane needs some healing. Can I get her? Yep, I can. Okay. I'm gonna heal up Sane, because he's probably the one I'm gonna end up sending after their command. Although... Yeah, I forgot. Loan's actually a pretty good fighter, too. I mean, maybe not so much on strength, but he's kind of tanky, so... As you can see, he's got a higher hit point and more defense, and he's a lower level. So I might end up just giving the heavy... I'm trying to think of who I want to give the heavy lance to. Because they can both use it. Every single cavalry unit I have can use a heavy lance. Even she can use a heavy lance. I think the heavy lance... Or heavy lance is a D. It is, and it's effective against knights. So... Alright, well, I'll tell you what. I'm going to move these guys up a little bit to make some space. And then, how do I want to do this? That's the big question. How do I want to deal? I'll tell you what I do want to do. I want to get my mage out of there. If I can get my mage up and hitting him, I probably should have been focusing on that. Oh, he only has a javelin. Maybe I don't want my mage. Maybe I don't want to use the weaker ranged units. Will should be alright because he has a decent defense, or better than Urk's anyway. So he might be okay. I might have Oswin go up and start chucking spears at him. Because Oswin actually has a really good defense. Keep Priscilla around. Probably won't use her as much. And I might actually use Elwood as well because of the rapier. Or actually Lin's Manny Caddy does the same thing. Pretty much any of my heroes I could use for this guy. I just need to figure out which ones I do want to use. I think I'm definitely going to have Sane, give Sane the Heavy Spear and have Sane go at him. Ooh, that's low end. That's not Sane. Actually, what items does he have? Well, if he has a javelin, I might have him be a ranged attacker. Alright, so first... Oh, crap! I can only have one person at a time up next to him. I guess everyone who doesn't go is gonna have to be a ranged attacker. Oh, are you kidding me? 51. Oh, that is abysmal. Hold on. What is Elwood's damage? What is Elwood's damage? What is Elwood's to hit? Is the other thing. He will do... Okay, he'll take a bit of damage, but he'll do... I know what I can... I know exactly what I can do. We'll have Elwood hit him. Then... Rescue! And move everyone back here. Then we'll move... Ooh. I'm trying to think of how I want to do this. Yeah, I think I'll have him come up with an axe. Oh! And that's going to be the end of it, it looks like. I was freaking out over nothing. And Marcus is going to handle it. Oh, jeez. I feel like I am wasting Marcus now looking at it. I feel like that was a terrible idea. Giving Marcus any say in any of this. I should have just left him behind. Maybe then Dorcas will still be alive. Damn you, Marcus. Oh, apparently it has to be Elderwood, does it? You know, normally, it says, actually... It says in the tutorials and in other places, if you use any lord, it'll take over that castle, but... So far, I've only been able to do it with Elderwood. And Elderwood will seize that. And Lynn will thank us for our help. Yep. So now we have 5 new units to replace the one that we lost. Well, I guess 2 so far. So that is now Rebecca dead and Dorcas dead as well. Oh look, Lynn's gonna scold him for being an idiot. She kind of makes a good point though. Like, if you're just wildly swinging an axe at people, that's probably not a good thing. It's probably not the way you want to fight. It'd be like if you gave someone a machine gun and they just started spraying everyone that they could see. Little bit problematic. So, I wouldn't praise him. He's terrible. He hasn't done anything before. Oh, and now we're going to have another little meet and greet like we've had for the past several parts. Yep. Good to see you again. All the people show up. There's Will, and then Florina is going to come out. And, bit of reminiscing. Yeah, I know it's not the best time to catch up. We're about to charge this freaking castle. Yep. You know, this guy has, like, the worst luck ever, because in the prologue, he was being poisoned by his brother, and now he's being held hostage by another lord, by a marquis in another area of the country. And now he's just been assassinated. Yeah, that's gotta suck. You survive an assassination attempt by your brother, and then you fall to one by another dude. And as you can see, and again, I've mentioned this before, the deeper they go, the more Lord Darin kind of has to rationalize. And it does seem like they did a good job setting it up. Like he gets angry first and like, well, no, I guess it makes sense we had to kill. I mean, he was in the way, you know. I wasn't the one who killed him. He should have just like worked with me, which is exactly how that kind of stuff starts. And yet again, he's going to bugger off and leave his men to die. And now we're going to meet Layla, who is a member of this, I think it's called the Black Fang. Yep. So they're going to finish him off, and that's going to be the end of this chapter. So, yeah, next time, the next part is going to be us trying to take back this castle. It is a bit difficult if memory serves. I think the biggest problem with this one was I got cocky because I got more people. Because, you know, obviously I got two more Cavaliers, I got Lynn back, I got another Archer, and then I lost an Axe guy. I mean, I don't really use the Axe wielders that often anyway. Most of the time I wait for, like, other people who just can't get Axes in Standard. So, like, you know, the Paladins can use Axes, Wyvern Knights can use Axes. If you upgrade, who is it? I'm trying to think of who else gains the ability to use axes, because, like, especially certain units, when they upgrade, they gain axe as an additional thing. Mercenaries, which we're about to get one of them, we'll get another one later. When they upgrade to heroes, they get axes. So yeah, we'll have plenty of other people who can use axes, and we'll actually get another couple, I think. We'll get a berserker, at least. We'll get at least one berserker. We'll get a pirate, who also uses axes. And then we'll get... I think there's another fighter we're gonna get later on as well, who will help. Actually, no, it's a warrior if memory serves, which is the upgraded fighter. So we'll be fine. It's a bit depressing. Dorcas died. He will never see his wife again, and that is so unfortunate. Not as unfortunate as Rebecca, who left home and then almost immediately was murdered by a swordsman. But it's still kind of tragic. So, next time we'll do the castle, I will kill some more things, probably lose another unit or two, because that's the way this has been going for me. But in the meantime, thanks as always for watching, guys. I was Ben, and this was Fire Emblem. See you next time, everyone.